Oscar Duarte. He's about to head to Saudi Arabia. Same card, Jose Ramirez. 48 hours to the flight to Saudi.
Right.
Heading out on Wednesday.
Yep.
Excited?
Yeah, man. No, we're excited.
This was a great training camp. Great sparring. Oscar Duarte will be there too. And one more fighter, right?
Little Virgil's making his way up there too to watch him.
You gonna be there?
Virgil Ortiz, yeah.
That's awesome. You always were Virgil Ortiz's favorite fighter.
Yeah, he's always told me that.
And the funny part is, the first time you guys sparred, he didn't realize it was you. Because he just goes in there to spar.
Yeah, the first time I sparred, like I sparred anybody, you know? And he told me, today we're gonna jump in with this guy. He's pretty strong, he's good. Because the first thing I taught Robert is like, hey, you know, I want the best one. So he knows that about me. So he was like, hey, you know, young, 140, 147 pounder. That will give you good work, and he sure did.
I actually have that video. I posted it.
That was a couple years after.
How good is Virgil Ortiz, Jose?
He's good. I mean, he's strong. You know, he has a lot of power, and he's smart too. Though he's very smart. Just little things that most people might not. As fans, you know, like you don't. They're so small movements that you might not catch them, but when you're in there with them, they work, they're very effective.
And he hits very hard. Yeah. So let me ask you this. By the way, you had a shirt of Muhammad Ali. Today's Mike Tyson. Where do you have these shirts from?
They're from Retro Collection out there in Fresno, but you can find them online.
He takes care of you.
Retro Collection, yeah.
But I noticed you wore Muhammad Ali at the press conference.
He's a hardworking young man, business owner, who's, you know, who has some great, he has great merchandise. And he also prints, like the hat that you're wearing, he prints those hats.
I'll show people today. That's your company, right? Your dad's company?
Yeah, that's our farm labor contracting logo.
So are you done sparring? How you doing, Robert?
I'm doing good, bro. I don't know. He's sparring today.
Last sparring session in America?
Probably Wednesday morning, early.
Oh, wow.
Early
morning, then?
I take off.
Are you flying in a private jet?
No.
You should. But at least business class, right?
Oh, yeah.
Oscar looks shredded today. Look at Oscar. Oscar, you're looking strong right now. He's ready. Really nice guy.
He shows up like that, man.
You think he's like that even when he's not in camp?
All year. This is about, I guess, a year. It's always...
They changed his opponent, by the way.
I heard that last week, right?
You have a new opponent. Oscar, new opponent.
Yeah.
Someone you sparred. What's his name? ¿Cómo se llama?
Batir
Abdullayev.
Yeah.
You know Batir?
Yeah.
So he has a new opponent. So Robert just landed. He just came back from a Ray Muratayas fight. Did you happen to see that one? Sensational knockout.
Of course. Oh, yeah. I mean, Raymond, he's ready for the 135 champions.
Him and Loma. Him and Tank. Him, who else do other two champions at 35?
He's another young guy.
Another Ukrainian? Yeah. I think he beats that other Ukrainian easy. The WBO champ. Yeah. Him and Haney.
They're talking about him fighting for the IBF. You're saying that Loma might make it about. He might retire or something.
That'd be sick. You fought Loma.
In the amateurs,
yeah. Yeah, but I'm saying, you never fought him in the pros, though.
No.
You can move up one weight class to 140.
I would have loved to, but, you know, I got too big and I couldn't make 135. And he was a smaller guy, he couldn't.
Watch out. You're good. It's bring your kid to school day. A work day.
Yeah, and I got my kids, eh? They're playing with me.
Oh, amazing. Wow.
Well, two of them. Two out of the three.
The big ones. That's exciting. That makes a big difference. That's good motivation.
Yeah, man. And I want them to enjoy the journey, too, you know?
Well, now they're old enough to appreciate it. When they were younger, they... I remember going to fights when they were just babies.
Yeah, Mateo, he's 9 years old. He's opening meat stock. He's trying to Ronaldo.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah, he'll be there. I think Messi's better.
Yeah. They're both...
No, they're both great, but one has to be better.
Yeah. I was a big Barcelona fan.
Are you excited to meet Ronaldo if he's there? Are you going to tell him, hey, you're good, but Messi's better? Is that your favorite fighter? Player, sorry.
Oh, this kid loves him.
No, he's very talented. He has very good...
I love Barcelona now.
You love Barcelona now? Who's your best player right now?
Ronaldo. Barcelona got me new.
Ronaldo plays in Saudi, they probably gave him like $500-800 million or something.
Yeah, I know, he's talking about the young, he's from Spain, a young guy who plays for Barcelona.
Well, your son might play for Barcelona one day.
Yeah, you know, if he stays focused and disciplined.
Would you like to play for Barcelona one day?
Depends.
What? Depends on what?
It depends if Barcelona scouts me.
If they scout you. They'll scout you. They scout. They go all over the world and they scout people. You're 9, right?
In the Saudi League, I like Al Nassr, but in the La Liga, I like Barcelona. But in the Champions League, I like Manchester City.
What about in America?
You said Miami.
Okay. What about, I'm gonna ask you one more. What about in Mexico? What's your team?
Oh, Chivas.
That's right. At least he knows his soccer.
He knows the soccer.
Robert. Jose's son told me his favorite Mexican team is Chivas.
No, he knows better. He knows it's America. He knows better. Like Mexico? No? Oh, you Chivas? I thought you were America. Mexico, America?
I already knew that. He's too busy watching the Europe League.
Yeah, those are the best players. Everybody ends up there. That was a good leagues, I think, in China and Japan. Hey, listen. Everybody in this gym tells me soccer's hard. I told them it's the easiest sport, the easiest.
Yeah.
Thank you for agreeing with me. Finally, someone here that makes sense.
He loves it. He's 9 years old. That's all he wants to do.
It's fun.
And he doesn't realize what it comes to.
Listen. Your dad knows, you know, do good in school, don't do drugs, don't drink.
If you would ask me when I was 8 years old or 9 years old, and I had like 15 amateur fights when I was 9, when I was his age, if you would ask me if boxing was hard or easy, I would have said it's easy.
No, boxing's hard. Boxing.
Yeah, at that age when I was 9. I loved fighting.
But you're an Olympian, you're a unified champion at 140, yeah, but, so of course it's easy for you. But it's hard.
It's hard. Boxing's tough, man, but I'm saying like the innocence of a child, you know, when they're having fun and enjoying it. You're gonna love it.
Jose, I played all kinds of sports. I gotta tell you, the easiest one I ever played was soccer. Basketball, you need to be tall. Boxing, you have to have power and speed and a chin.
I think boxing's the hardest.
It is the hardest.
I'm a boxer. I mean, to endure all the adversity that comes with boxing, not just in the ring, but everything.
By the way, are you guys Dodger fans? Are you a Dodger fan? You're happy they won?
Yeah. I threw the little pitch over there.
Over there, yeah. And you know what happened to me? I came to watch your dad throw the first pitch. And I don't like baseball that much. I think it's boring. I'm sorry. I don't have 4 hours a day to burn on baseball.
He said it was hard when he pitched.
Oh, I'm sure it's hard. But listen, I wanted to leave right after the pitch, right?
Yeah.
They locked me in a parking lot with a gate, and I couldn't leave till after the game. That was kind of messed up. They kind of keep you hostage for the whole game.
On my test, it said who made the Yankees lost the World Series. I said the pitcher, and I got criticized about it.
I think it's a team effort. I can't blame one person. Boxing, you could blame the fighter or blame the coach, but in baseball, a team. Soccer, can you blame one player?
Huh?
Can you blame one player in soccer if a team doesn't win?
Not anymore.
Why not?
Fernandez.
So you're excited to go to Saudi?
Yeah.
Have you been there before?
Have
you done research? Have you read about it? Googled what is Saudi? What are you going to see? How old is the country? How many people live there?
No.
Why not? All those. What language do they speak? Arabic.
Yeah.
You want to learn some? I'll teach you some basic phrases. Ahlan wa sahlan.
Tempo.
That's hello. Ahlan. Shu esmek. What's your name? Min wen ente, where are you from? Oh, you want to see someone? Come over and say, Ta'al lehon. You're going to be flowing. By the time you come back, you're going to be speaking more than anybody. Right? But that's exciting.
You know, kids pick up everything. Mateo's going to.